And welcome back, everybody, to Sports Weekly on IEMG. We are still waiting for a high school football season. We're hoping it will start early in 2021, but exactly when, we just don't know yet. It was scheduled to begin on January 8th, but that's going to be delayed. We might even have a shortened season, but we're hoping to still have a season nonetheless. And a lot of high school football teams are working out. That's exactly what they're doing at Indian Springs High School as head coach Chris Chaddick is trying to keep his team ready. Better to stay ready than have to get ready, right? So they are working out. They're doing conditioning, trying to get the guys together. And of course, there's a lot of safety protocols in place. There's smaller groups. They do it in pods. They space them out across the stadium. So there's a lot of things that they do to ensure that they can have these workouts and they can do it safely. So here's our exclusive interview with Indian Springs head football coach Chris Chaddick talking about how the Coyotes workouts are going and what he thinks. When will a high school football season take place here in San Bernardino and beyond? Here's our interview with Coach Chaddick. Well, football conditioning continues right now with that start date still January 8th as of right now. We'll see if that changes, but as of right now, football team's still preparing, including Indian Springs, the Coyotes, and head coach Chris Chaddick join us here on the show right now. In fact, from a football workout at Indian Springs High School Stadium. So Coach Chaddick, my first question is, how are the workouts going? How are your guys responding to all this?
Oh, you know, these guys are so glad to be here. They're in great spirits because it's the first time some of them have been together since school got out in March. So it's the first time some of these guys have been together, had that camaraderie. I mean, just take a look at these guys just having fun over here. Just some of these guys are doing what they got to do. And I got the linemen over there just doing everything, you know, and then another group over here. I mean, there's Coach Headland over there. They're having a great time. Just the fellowship alone, they're having a great time, and it isn't real football, but it's better than nothing, and we're adapting and overcoming.
Coach, what about the logistics of it? Because, you know, you and I were talking a little bit off camera that you've got pods and you've got different groups and they can't really cross paths and you got to spread them out. I mean, there's a lot of logistical things as a head coach that I guess you have to plan for, right, to have these workouts actually happen.
Oh, yes. That started first and foremost with great leadership from the top. John Chamberlain came up with a great plan of action. Him and Matt Maida were pretty much the lead dogs in the return to play program. And those dudes did a great job coming up with the way we should have our pods separated. I mean, you saw us at a couple places. We were doing field trips, doing everything we could, seeing what worked at schools, what didn't work. And, you know, we kind of just took what was best for us. And, you know, we took the field trips. We saw the Steinbergs. We saw Bird Espo at Temecula Valley. And we just kind of just took their great ideas and combined them with the ideas that our ADs had. And we're just putting it to work. As you can see right here, back here, we got some pods that are socially distant doing their thing. And, you know, we just stagger them, like just like I said, stagger them into different groups and different times. And it works out well.
So, Coach, I know January 8th right now is that date where football is scheduled to have its first game of the season. I know a lot of that stuff is still up in the air. What's kind of your message to the kids in terms of, you know, I know it sounds kind of cliche, but control what you can control.
Well, one of the things we talk about all the time is you really know a lot about who you are as a man when you're facing adversity and things aren't the greatest. This isn't ideal. This isn't perfect. This isn't what we want. But, you know, our guys, they come and they work hard and they're learning. And, you know, these guys, I don't know if you know, but the San Bernardino schools voted to stay at a school the whole year. So the fact that these guys are out here doing something they love and, you know, being able to fellowship with one another, that's a victory in and of itself. So we look for the small victories every day. And that's all you can do. Look for the small victories every day. You know, and we talk about our slogan this year is victory requires payment in advance. these are the dues we got to pay if we're going to make the playoffs. And I do believe we'll have a season. I mean, it might be shortened, who knows, but we'll have one. And I preach that optimism, and no matter what happens, these guys have handled themselves with class and dignity, and I'm so proud of them.
Coach, you know, here we are again with January 8th as that date right now for that first game of the season, and it looks probably likely that the season will be, like you said, maybe shortened, maybe pushed back even a little bit further. You know, does your gut have a hunch how the next couple of weeks might look like, or how this might kind of play out?
The big thing is, as long as we're in phase one, which we are, and our county is in that purple or whatever goalpost zones that our King Newsom has going on, we're going to be going by that. And as long as there's like a second wave going on, I just see us kind of in a holding pattern. And with the announcement that CIF made today, we're in a definite holding pattern. So all we can do is control what we can control. I can't speculate and think about whether we're going to have a season or not. I just would rather have hope, have optimism, because if we don't have hope and we don't preach hope to these kids and we don't show hope to these kids and we aren't hopeful ourselves, I mean, what's the purpose of being out here?
And finally, Coach, because I know I want to let you get back to work out there. I know those workouts are important. You know, if we do have a season, you got to have your guys ready, especially, you know, physically. I know X's and O's, you'll have your guys dialed in. But how important is it right now to just make sure that, you know, assuming we have a season at some point, that their bodies are ready too, that their fitness level's high enough. And maybe at some point you guys are able to, you know, do a little weight work, you know. I don't know if you physically go in the weight room or you take some of the equipment outside or how that looks. But, you know, you got to just make sure you're physically ready for a season, right?
Right. We have some people that are helping us out. We have a lady out here, Miss Sane. She's a soccer coach, actually helps out a little bit, one of the PE teachers. She helps us out with the mobility and the warm-ups so that our guys are supple before we even work out. And that's a big thing a lot of people ignore in this time. They just have their guys like, most coaches, I would say all coaches, but there are some coaches that just have their guys just blaze of glory, but we got our guys being supple and being prepared. We got a warm up that's very, very dynamic beforehand, and then we get into what we got to get into. So it's baby steps. We'll be allowed, I think, in a week. Once we get our cleaning supplies, that's another thing. We were supposed to start having our outdoor equipment practices this week, but we haven't gotten our spray, where myself and the four other coaches on the staff had to get janitor training to learn how to spray the equipment. We're getting all that stuff this week, hopefully, and we can, you know, bring out the box jump stuff and the medicine balls and all that, and once we have the sanitary equipment to do so. So till then, you know, we're just easing into things and doing the best we can. And a lot of these guys, I'm proud to say, the core group did work, so they don't look sloppy, so I'm very happy.
Well, Coach, I know this year being a head football coach at the high school level has taken on a whole new meaning on so many different levels. You just mentioned it. You have to be, I don't know, sanitation certified to make sure your players are going to be safe if they're using the weight equipment. I there's so many things, so many moving parts, I guess I should say, as a head coach. So I applaud you and all the head coaches out there who are doing such a great job right now.
Thank you very much. I appreciate that greatly, Pep. And thank you very much for really covering inland sports and doing a great job. Man, been with you since the beginning, been seeing you since the beginning. It's a pleasure. So thank you very much.
All right. Well, Coach, I know time is valuable. You only have so much time with these guys at the workouts. I'm going to let you go, but we do appreciate you checking in from one of your Coyote football workouts. That's head coach Chris Chaddick from Indian Springs High School. Join us here on Sports Weekly on IEMG. Thanks again, Coach.
Okay. Thank you. Keep the faith.
That's going to do it for this edition of Sports Weekly on IEMG. I hope you enjoyed those great interviews with local coaches and athletic directors as we talk about the start of the high school sports season. And we're all waiting. We're still waiting to find out when that will exactly be, when we can have real games here in San Bernardino. My name is Pep Fernandez. We appreciate you tuning in. If you haven't done so, hit that subscribe button for us on the IE Media Group YouTube channel. We'll see you next time on Sports Weekly on IEMG.